have our liquid flow 30M machine. This is a gear pump driven machine with our new HMI that allows you to have all of the settings on the PLC, along with low level sensors. There is recirculation going from the valve back into the reservoirs. We have silica gel traps to catch moisture in the air, along with the air nucleation and agitation for the Part B reservoir, and a heating jacket to heat up that material. And then for the other material, we have a nitrogen air purge ball valve that allows you to put a blast of nitrogen in the reservoir to isolate the material from any moisture that might be in the air. Typical machine options for the liquid flow 30M. You have programmable functions with different recipes that include a flow rate, a shot amount or a shot size, along with the mix ratio. Right now we have it at 1.25:1 by weight, and you can name the Part A and the Part B materials how you would like. In this case, we have the Part A labeled as white and the Part B labeled as clear. Anti-gel functions and zone one of heating. There is one heating circuit on this machine for the Part B material reservoir, and then agitation, recirculation, and air nucleation. With it being a foam machine, those are all required to properly handle the materials. Your typical fault screen, right now there's low level and the flow rate is below what this machine is able to do, along with the emergency stop for now. So when we reset those functions, again, the low level is going off with the light indicator. We will go ahead and mute that buzzer. Going back to the screen, we have it in operator control, where right now the material will dispense for as long as the trigger is held in. Or if we go to timed shot, that's where it will dispense 55 cc's at a flow rate of 500 cc's a minute, and again with the mix ratio of 1.25:1. And mixer valve open. On this machine, we have the ability to set the anti-gel timings, along with the buzzer mute and warning times. Also very cool with the liquid flow 30M machines is you can name the Part A and Part B, or component one and component two material, as you wish. In this case, we have the Part A material, or component one, is white, and the component two, or Part B, is clear. So we chose those to make it very user-friendly. In the engineer screen, you can change the flow rate, shot amount, along with isolating one pump at a time. So you can turn off the Part A pump and only run the Part B pump, or the white material or clear material. In the heatings, you have the ability to adjust the set point of the temperature that you would like. It's in Celsius, so for this, for example, if we change it to 40 degrees Celsius, it will tell you the actual temperature and what you have it set at. I'm going to change that back down to 30. That will rise to that temperature. You can turn that heating on or off. The low level stop. This machine has low level alarms. You can choose to allow the machine to continue to run below level. In this case, we have a little amount of material, so we have that low level stop off. Back to the main screen, we have the agitation on, recirculation on, and the air injection on. Again, these are needed functions to properly handle foam materials.
In order to do a mixed ratio test, you have to isolate the part A and part B streams. You do that by removing the rotary static attachment pin. And then there is one stream and there is another stream. We have our handheld, trigger-actuated, rotary static recirculation valve, where both materials will stay separate until the very end of this valve, where you will attach the rotary static valve, and this motor will spin those elements inside, assisting the blend of those materials. Put on the rotary static mixer, which is the only day-to-day consumable, using our shroud to keep it in place on the end of the valve. When the materials are not being dispensed through the rotary static mixer valve, they are being sent back to the machine reservoirs, conducting the recirculation to keep the materials blended with air, nucleated with air. And again, it is a lightweight handheld valve on the end of a 2 meter hose. Again, both materials are separate until the very end of that valve. Both the materials are pourable, flowable liquids. They go in their separate reservoirs and latched into place. Right here we have a low level alarm that I will mute. And then on the base resin side, we have the heated reservoir along with the air nucleation, so that you can pump the air into the foam, which makes that reaction that foam materials need and require. Place.